Hello and welcome to ESPN Cricinfo Match Day. We're building up to that game versus Kolkata Knight Riders and Mumbai Indians. This will be played in Kolkata and this is match number 47 in the IPL. I'm Nikhil Naz, with me Murali, Kartik, Shaun, Tait. Let's quickly take a look at how is it that these two teams have performed against each other across all IPL season. This is their head-to-head record, and if you were to see that, Mumbai clearly hold an edge there in the 23 times that they've played each other, 18-5. Now that's a very big advantage as far as the head-to-head record is concerned. Since 2016 also, it's massive, 7-0. And then at the Eden Gardens, you've got Mumbai winning 7-2 to Kolkata. So any way you look at it, it just seems like that Mumbai Indians go in as the favorites. Okay, we'll start with the issues that both teams need to address. Shaun, we'll start with you on this one.
Who would you like me to address here?
You could go with any team that you'd like, yeah?
I'll go with Kolkata.
Kolkata, yeah. Kolkata, because I guess they have more issues to be
addressed. Look, they do. I mean, yeah, we obviously go over these. We talked about some of their batting situation. Players in different spots, they probably haven't quite got that right this year. And through the middle order, they've sort of obviously relied on Russell a bit and some guys at the top. Okay, Nitish Rana's played pretty well, but I just don't think they've figured out their batting positions throughout the tournament, and it's been a bit late. But look, apart from that, I suppose their bowling has lacked a little bit of bite, a little bit of penetration. I suppose you've got Harry Gurney's coming. Russell's starting to bowl quicker again now. He's sort of, the last couple of games, he's been up in the 140s, but before that he was lacking a bit of pace. And so their overseas seam is, apart from Ferguson, there's no real pace and penetration. So. They've lacked a bit there, and obviously we talk about their spin bowlers have struggled a little bit as well.
Since he's done all the hard work, the tougher team to figure out problems for Mumbai don't have too many, but if you were to see any areas of concern.
No, look, just a couple of things, because they've been perennial slow starters, and not massively. For them, Rohit Sharma's form might have been a bit of a concern, because he's got starts without converting them, because he's such a good player. Yesterday was a match-winning innings from him on that surface. Krunal Pandya's batting, that's the only thing, because apart from that, they've got a well-rounded bowling attack, two of the best death bowlers. Rahul Chahar has been bowling really, really well. Krunal Pandya, two chips in. And so they've got a well-rounded side. So just these couple of things to iron out.
Okay, we'll take a look at any changes that Kolkata can do to their playing 11. We got Shaun to pick the playing 11. Yes, there are a lot of concerns that they need to address, according to you, but nothing needs to be changed in the 11, you reckon?
The only thing is, I just think if you're playing against... if you're playing against Mumbai, you've got Pollard and Pandya and these guys, I'd be tempted to play someone like a Lockie Ferguson. Just with a bit of extra pace. Like I was saying, they're lacking a bit of penetration. Yeah. Even when he's played, he hasn't done that well. But I just think against Mumbai, maybe a guy like Ferguson on this wicket, which actually skips through pretty well, he's probably not a bad change. So that's the only thing I would talk about.
Right, that change would make sense as well. We saw the young Indian fast bowlers really not doing it for the Kolkata team the game before this. Okay, we're taking a look at Kartik's playing 11 for Mumbai Indians. And just like Shaun, no changes for
you
as
well?
Not
for me, nothing at all. Because I'm happy to see Evan Lewis get a game. Evan Lewis on this surface would be brilliant because of the fact
The only thing you've made a change, I can see, is the batting order. Last time around, Surya Kumar Yadav was pushed to some number 7.
No, not me. No, I've not made that playing 11. I think someone else
but
has made it.
But you would still have him there?
I would have him at number 3 because Surya Kumar Yadav is doubly dangerous later on. Evan Lewis at number 3 because if Rohit Sharma has to bat and Quinton de Kock has to open, then you want them at the top. But on this surface, I think it's just tailor-made for somebody like Evan Lewis with the ball coming on. Good to see a young player getting a debut against Chennai. So hopefully he's persisted with. So, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't want to make any changes there.
Right. So you would still have Surya Kumar Yadav batting at
lower
6, 7, whatever.
Just 3 good power hitters over there.
Okay. Now, taking a look at players to watch out for. And then we've got Murali, Kartik to pick a player for Mumbai Indians and Shaun to pick a player for Kolkata Knight Riders. And this is the player that Shaun's picked in Shubman Gill. You're expecting him now to fire after a few dry or, say, I could say, bad
run? Yeah. I mean, he's a very good player and going to be a very good player. So just be nice to see him get some runs again against Mumbai as well, against a big team like that. I think if he got runs against Rohit Sharma and these guys, he'd be happy with that. And the innings would stand out. And I think that's what they need, their batting order. You know, you can't keep relying on the same guys. I think a nice half century or even a century from him would be nice. Yeah.
Talking about getting into some form, and good form was shown by Quinton de Kock as well, start of the tournament, and then just bit tapered off a bit. You're expecting him now to fire?
No, I think he's been in fine form. The odd blip is always going to happen in a long tournament where you're travelling day in, day out. You can't, it's not like a pre-programmed machine that you're going to get the same performance. Mm. But he's been brilliant. I think when Rohit has not fired, he's been the one who's been there and getting the kind of starts which Mumbai have gotten so far. Mm. So I still feel that he's the player to watch out for.
None of you have picked Rohit Sharma. This is Eden Gardens. Rohit Sharma loves playing at the Eden Gardens.
We don't
Gardens
want to
every time.
Put the mockers on him, that's all.
Okay. You want him to be in good form. Yeah, he's struck some good
form. It's too obvious to pick.
Yes, he is. He loves playing at that ground. He's done rather well for India as well.
You picked predictions. Him. You picked him.
They never asked me for players
You have given
out
it
for.
On your own. Just like Andre Russell gave it on his own that I want to bat at number four. You have given it on your own.
Okay, time to make a prediction.
I'm thinking Mumbai.
Yes.
Mumbai.
Yes.
Well, that doesn't augur well.
What do you say? You make your prediction.
For the Kolkata Knight Riders, because they've lost six in a row. They wouldn't want it seven in a row. But
I think if they lose this, that could be the end for them.
Yep.
That's probably going to be.
They'll still have a mathematical chance, but as you're saying, it'll be out of their hands from there on. Yeah,
Arya Bhatta can save them then.
That's correct. Okay. So they'd want their fortunes in their own hand, Kolkata Knight Riders. But if they were to lose this match, then unfortunately, it could be curtains for them in this tournament. You're watching ESPN CricInfo Match Day.
Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and leave your comments in the comment section below. Click on the bell icon for notifications.